Sanyika, what's up?
You got two, player.
Hey, I got the message you was trying to send,
mm-hmm.
but you know, they had me on the Hannibal Lecter trip.
Yeah, I was wondering what happened, because they do that to me, too, when I was up in there.
Yeah, I heard.
Certain people I couldn't write to, like Matulu, they opened my whole letter to him.
Oh, yeah. Well, you know, I would get at Matulu, but I would go around a long way, right?
Uh-huh.
Through this cat named Robin.
Uh-huh.
Or I get at Watani, I go another way, too, right?
But well, I was scared to do that shit. I didn't want nobody else to get the letter, because this other cat wrote me and said that you talked to him and it was cool to send it through him, but I was like, shit.
Yeah.
I know he said that.
Right.
Everybody know I'm trying to get at you.
Hey, that was a good shout-out you gave me, man, in the vibe, man.
Oh, you know it's all real, man. I've been trying to tell you to your face for the longest time.
I'm telling you, but you don't remember when we met, huh?
Nah.
Over McCool.
Watani said it was up in L.A., right?
Straight up, man.
I don't remember that shit.
Me and you, I'm thinking who was. It was me, you, it was Yakasizwe, Asanea, Dara, we was kicking over Makungu's pad.
I still don't remember that shit.
Yeah.
You know, I'll be butted out, though.
Son. I know, homie. Hey.
There ain't no secret.
Hey, you got my number here, though.
Nah.
You called me, remember?
But I got that number from Mo. He was with me. He dialed the number for me.
Okay, take this number down.
Go ahead.
909-243-2889.
2889.
Hey, you know we start shooting the movie next month, right?
You do?
I'm telling you, man, I want you to play me, man.
I want to play you.
Okay, dig this.
Nobody play you.
Dig this. Check us out. The producer, director, right,
mm-hmm.
is Antoine Fuqua, young brother, 28 years old, from Baltimore, right? But he's straight up cat like us, right?
Mm-hmm.
And he's a good cat. We got hella pull with him, right?
Mm-hmm.
We ain't even did casting yet, man.
Mm-hmm.
You know?
You got to put me down.
I'm telling you.
Got to play.
I'm telling you, I didn't see your shit. I just seen Juice.
Oh, you did?
Because I was locked up all them years.
Oh, shit.
I just seen your shit, man.
Word.
Yeah.
I just
wrote the rim. What was that, last night? Yeah.
When I was up in that jailhouse, I wrote one, too. I'm supposed to be getting that shit together. What else you doing, man?
Hey, man, you wouldn't believe I got some dope-ass lyrics.
What?
I'm serious. I got some shit called Level 5 that's bomb shit.
What?
Wait up. Hey, homie, I'm talking about, hey.
You got to come in the studio then.
I'm telling you, I got some shit.
So when you going to come through?
When can I come through?
Anytime you want. I'm in the studio every day. I'm finishing my album. I'm doing a double album this Christmas called All Eyes on Me.
Hey, man, hey, I'm telling
you. I got the song with Dre. I got the song with Roger. I got a song with George Clinton.
That shit is fat. Hey,
I got Sister Soldier coming. If you come, nigga, we could do the bomb.
I'm telling you.
Together.
Hey, check this out. Check this out. I'm telling you, that shit you shot, man, so many tears.
Yeah.
I mean, I burst out in tears when I heard that shit.
You like that shit?
Man, you shot that shit. I'm telling you, yesterday I was cleaning up the pad.
Uh-huh.
And I was, me and my wife, right?
Mm-hmm.
And I was cleaning up the pad, and, Lord Knows was on, right?
Uh-huh.
And that, the last verse,
yeah.
that shit hit me and froze me, man.
That's the one, man.
Man, hey, homie, I love the shit out of you, man. You shot that shit.
Player,
I'm
partner.
Telling you, brother. I'm telling you.
You my player. I was telling you. It was this letter I was trying to say to you, man. When them dudes put out the pistols to me.
Man, who was that, man?
It was these fools from New York, this gang out there called A-Team. These
man.
Fools was mad because I told them I wasn't fucking with them no more.
Man, them motherfuckers, I was mad as hell about that shit.
But when they pulled the pistols out, I swear on everything I love, first thing I thought about was reading in your book when you was talking about how you felt when them niggas drew down on you.
Ain't that cold?
That's exactly how I felt. The setup, the shit you was talking
man,
about,
shit,
how you just look up and the nigga be like, boom,
right there
bullet.
At you.
Everything was just like that.
When I was reading about the shit that happened to you, I was like, man, this shit is straight like parallel to me.
It's exactly
I'm telling you, can't nobody
bug me out.
Man, I'm telling you, we start shooting in December, man, and no ladies in January.
Mm-hmm.
And Propaganda's doing it, right?
Oh, that's good.
Propaganda's doing it with PolyGram.
Uh-huh.
And with the shit is already, man, I'm telling you, I'm going to plug you in, man. I'm telling you, can't nobody do this shit but you. We're going to have that Shakur thing.
All right, I'm going to blow it up.
We're going to have that Shakur thing.
Hey, I represent it for you.
I'm telling you.
All of New York. I got all those New York dudes who hate the West Coast screaming out your name.
Hammering that shit.
I was passing your autobiography to niggas because they didn't understand the West Side.
I'm telling you, hey, I seen you on BET one time. It was you and John Singleton, right?
Yeah.
And you asked John Singleton, you read that book, Do or Die? And he said, yeah, have you read Eat to Live? And Watani was there, too.
Uh-huh.
Yeah. I've been following you, brother.
Yeah, man. John Singleton a coward, though.
Yeah, I also heard what you did to the Hughes brothers.
Yeah, man.
I read that article that interview Dream did with you.
Yeah. Hughes brothers was coward, too.
Yeah.
Man, I just been struggling out here looking for you, man. I need some help, man.
I'm telling you, I'm here, brother. Whatever I can do, man, I'm telling you straight up. I'm going to plug you in.
Got to, man.
I'm telling you, man. I'm telling you, Pocky.
And I want to get this organization started with you. Only we could do it. Let me tell you the idea. All
right.
It's like we start like this youth league, right?
Right.
Like football league, basketball, football, softball. For for girls and boys. I'm going to get all the rappers to adopt the team.
Right.
Each rapper have his own team. Coolio have his team. Tretch have his team. I have my team. And we play. And the rappers are the ones that put the money up. We get the field. We play.
Right.
We have, like, the churches come out and sell food.
That's real.
We had the fathers and the uncles and all of the men in the community. They do security.
Right.
Get their respect back for the kids and everything. Then we had the FOI come out. We had the deacons from the church. They do security. And we just play football, baseball, you know, get that community spirit going again.
I'm with it.
Then
man.
On the weekends, we have block parties.
All right.
And every rapper got to get up. Every rapper, nigga, if you got a record out, you got to get up for us. You got to come do a free show for the hood.
That's real.
And it's like a little tour.
That's
so we
real.
Do that. We get all the communities back together. Now, I'm talking to Al Sharpton about this, some other motherfuckers with some power. And then when we do that, we register the voters. And if we can register them for Democrats, Republican, or Independent.
Yeah.
Once we register the voters, we have power. Then we start going up to the mayors of these cities and telling them, look, we got this many voters in this city. We want you to do this. We want a community center. We start hitting up Nike for the free clothes, the computer stores for the free computers for each community center. And if they don't, then shit, that's how many people we have in those cities we can regulate. You know what I mean?
Yeah.
If we telling the mayor, nigga, if you don't do this, then we ain't going to do this.
Yeah.
We telling them we can clean up the streets. I'm going to have all these tough-ass, supposed to be gangster rappers.
Straight
we're
going
to all get in the van. We're going to travel. L.A. got to be the last place because it's going to be hardest. But we can do New Jersey, all of that. We're going to drive to all these drug areas, right?
Yeah.
Imagine me, Redman, Tretch, Ice Cube, them type of niggas getting out, going up to the... whoever's the main drug dealer on that block, who runs shit? You know, if we get out of a van, be like, what's up, nigga? How y'all doing? What's up? Yo, who the nigga that runs shit? They gonna take us to that nigga. We invite those niggas to dinner, invite them niggas to some Jean Perignon, steak and lobster, and be like, look, player, we asking you, not telling you, we asking you as a player to a player, can you please give us a pass to have these streets clean from 6 p.m. to 11 p.m., 6 a.m. to 11 p.m.
Right.
Let that be for the kids. Let them the niggas be safe during those times. No gunshots, no drug dealings. From 11 p.m. to 6 a.m., y'all can have the streets back. But let us get the streets from these times. Then we can get these politicians. I talked to Al Sharpton. He said he can get the police to, like, chill out on those nighttime patrols if niggas can get the streets clean from 6 to 11.
Hey, but, and you know what else, too, though? When I talk to you face-to-face, I'm going to drop some shit on you, right? Some other stuff, too, right?
Mm-hmm.
But, yeah, that's bad, man. You know, I'm with all that, right? And, you know, that's my type of work.
Yeah, we need power, man.
I'm telling you. Hey, dig it, man. You know, hey, I'm telling you, we got power, man.
Yeah, we need power. Power is numbers, and it's like we rappers,
you know,
man. While we don't have, we got the juice. We just ain't doing nothing with it.
It because it ain't collectivized.
Right.
I tell you what, did you see them cats in Chicago? I think they was GDs.
Yeah,
they put people in the street.
I know they be looking out for me when I come out there,
and they be running. They be running people on the ticket, like for councilman.
I know they got them. This dude, what's his name? Some nigga they just had out there, but he lost.
Yeah, Gator.
He came close. Gator, yeah.
Yeah.
He came close, though.
Yeah. Them was some good cats, too, man.
I went out there, they be looking out for me, but they be gang so, like, the one set want me to be down with them. And
yeah.
The Blackstones want me to be with them.
Yeah.
And GDs be with them. But, yeah, I had to run it with them in Milwaukee because that was when that little kid died. Yummy Sandifer.
Yeah, I heard you send a shout out to him.
Yeah, I did a show that next day after they just killed that kid.
Yeah. Because
you heard what happened, right?
Yeah, they executed him.
Right, they executed him. And I was out there when I did the show, the gang was in the fucking audience. The whole gang had, like, bought out the stadium.
Damn.
So I'm rapping to the niggas that just killed this little kid.
Oh.
And they all screaming out, thug life. And I felt bad. Like, wait
did
a minute,
you?
They got it twisted.
Yeah.
So I started cursing them niggas out. Like, y'all niggas is cowards. Y'all niggas cowards. Y'all killed that kid. Y'all niggas is punks, man. I hate all you niggas. I heard all you. Them niggas start throwing shit. We
had
out in the stadium.
Damn.
It was tough, man. The whole gang tore up the whole neighborhood. But then I started getting letters from that area where all, like, the mothers, the girls was writing me, like, thank you for doing that because everybody's scared of these niggas. See, that's what I want to do.
That's right.
I want to, if these gang niggas ain't going to get straight, then I want to take them out the gang.
That's real.
Because if they don't, it's making trouble on us.
Yeah,
you know,
because if you ain't part of the solution, then you're part of the problem.
No
and
doubt.
Therefore, you're going to be trying to whack us anyway.
No doubt.
See the fans? So, shit. You know, business as usual.
That's how I feel.
But just for the forces of good, man. You know, I'm with all that, Pac. You know, you anytime, anything I can do, brother, you know, that's what I'm about, man. I've always been less of a talker, more of a doer.
It's all good.
And, you know, I mean, that ain't, you know, that's just my style, man.
Yeah, no doubt. You talk to Bone?
Yeah, in fact, me and Bone.
He better do something, too.
Yeah, Bone is doing, when they shoot the movie, Bone's doing a documentary called The Making the Monster, right?
Oh, he is.
Yeah, and he's also doing another documentary, man, about street
gangbangers.
Yeah, about street organizations.
Yeah.
Got some old footage from the Panthers and stuff.
Yeah.
And, you know, the shit is fat, man. How's mom's doing?
She doing good. She just had a show in Vegas.
Did she?
We had a big ass show in Vegas, me and the dog, because I'm on death row now.
Yeah, hey, man, congratulations.
Thanks, man.
You happy over there?
Yes, all right, so far. So, right, hold on, let me tell you. Hold on 1 second.
All right. Hey, what's up with the case, though?
Shit, it's going crazy now. Damn, hold on 1 second, please. All
right.
You know I had the police case.
Yeah, and now I heard they wanted you to compensate them.
They tried to sue me.
What?
These fools shot at me.
And you defended yourself.
And they tried to sue me. And white people was crazy because if this was anybody else, they'd get that nigga a ticket tape parade.
Straight up.
Unarmed man. Two motherfuckers. That was fucked up.
Yeah.
So they suing me. I got this girl who lied about the rape shit. She's
smoking weed right now, huh?
Huh?
You smoking weed right now?
Nah, cigarette.
Oh.
I will be focusing with my homeboy finna come over here right now. But, the girl that did this rape shit, she hooked up with the niggas that shot me.
Oh, is that right?
It's all connected. It was a big plan. I just caught it, like, at the end, and that's why they shot me.
Man, hey, man, you gotta stay up, man. When you step through that way, man, you gotta be on point, bro.
I ain't going through there no more. If I do, I'm going with 100 motherfuckers.
Yeah, I'll be one of them.
Yep. No doubt.
We can't be having you not here, you know what I'm saying?
I know, that's what killed me, but you know what? You know what it was? Here's my problem. Just like I'm feeling you, what you're saying. I always, because of where my mom raised me, the way the movement is,
yeah,
they fucked my head up in a way. See, like you could be movement orientated, but you got the gangbang shit first in
right,
your mind.
Right.
My shit, the gangbang shit comes second to me.
Right.
And now I'm trying to make it come first because that movement shit will fuck you up. Movement shit got me loving every brother.
Yeah.
You know what I mean?
And therefore, you let every brother get next to you.
Right.
And every brother got a chance to whack you.
I'm there for you. You know what I mean?
Yeah,
nigga need
yeah.
money, a job, I'm with you.
But
niggas can come up to me with guns on. Niggas be hugging me with texts on. You know what I mean?
But dig this, though. You know what? The thing is, man, we got to be individuals, too, inside the movement and whatever we're involved in, right?
Mm-hmm.
Instance, we got to be able to differentiate between cats that are firm and cats that ain't firm. And sometimes it takes some type of a test, right?
Mm-hmm.
You know, but when we talk about, for instance, me, man, you know, I am who I am. I survived through what I survived through by being intelligent, by not allowing cats to outsmart me, put me in precarious positions where I can get whacked, right?
Mm-hmm.
So I choose my friends very, very carefully. And I understand that there's layers and layers of friends, you see?
Mm-hmm.
There's some I hold close to the body, man, like a vest, and there's others I hold at arm's distance, and some I just look at,
mm-hmm.
and some I don't even fuck with, right? But the circle is small, but the ones that are in there, I believe are trustworthy, right?
Mm-hmm.
For instance, you and I. You and I have been primarily through the same shit, man, in our lives.
Oh, God.
You know what I'm saying? And we're like 10 years apart, almost.
Mm-hmm.
So it's like you and I share a common, almost common destiny.
Mm-hmm.
You know, what you grew up in is what I came around to. You see what I'm saying? Like you pointed out that the banging shit was first with me, and then the movement. With you, the movement was first, and then the banging was came second.
Yes, that's the ill shit.
I'm getting around to where you grew up at.
And I'm getting around to where you grew up
you
at.
You see, so who else better? You see who can get along than you and I.
No
and,
doubt.
And watch each other's back. Because
no
you
doubt.
Want it, I want it.
No doubt.
Together, but you know what I mean? We,
yeah.
You know, you man, you got the courage of a gunfighter. When I read that shit, what happened when Dream Hampton wrote that piece,
mm-hmm.
down there with the pigs, right?
Yeah.
I was like, it's my boy, man.
No doubt.
You know what I'm saying?
See, that's another problem. I'm helping another nigga. Nigga, I don't even know.
Yeah.
Nigga in the middle of the street getting beat up. I'm helping him. He run off and don't even help me.
Yeah. That's fucked up, man.
These niggas just shot me. Like when the white cats pulled the gun on me, I was prepared. You know what I'm saying? know what I mean? Like, I can react. When a nigga pulled a gun on me, I like froze up like, oh shit, a nigga gonna kill me?
Yeah. I'm telling you, you know what we should do, Pac?
Hmm.
I'm telling you, me and you should sit down, right? And we should do a book on you, man.
Yeah?
You know what I'm talking about?
I'm trying to do that.
Check it out, man. A straight up autobiography or something like that based on your life, like Malcolm had sat down with Alex Haley.
Mm-hmm.
I'm telling you, man. Because the shit that you've been through and I've been through, just like my book, man, I had to document that shit.
Hey, your book is on everything, homie. I'm not just saying this. Your shit is a classic.
Okay.
Yo, it's niggas, when I was up in that jailhouse, niggas who hated Westside, they don't like nothing, they was loving you. I had motherfuckers speechless.
Is that
they was
right?
Reading, niggas that can't read, was reading your shit in one day.
Yeah.
Nobody could put that shit down.
But I'm telling you, hey, but yours would be just as explosive, and I'm telling you, brother, I guarantee you, before we even get through with the book, Hollywood would be on our jock.
No doubt.
I'm telling you, man.
They already want me to do something.
I'm telling you.
I've been holding them back because I can't get the right one. I asked, like, Maya Angelou to help me write an autobiography. She was like, okay,
man,
but it's a time thing.
You know what you need? And also, too, you know what you need? Somebody to write it from our level.
Yeah.
To kick the slang, to have this shit right. Maya Angelou might put some perfect English in that motherfucker.
And it ain't going to come out
right. You know, you and I, we're going to kick the language we kick.
That shit got to be like your shit.
I'm telling you.
Hey, but you know what you got to put me into?
What?
Overstand.
I'm telling you.
Put me into overstand,
that, okay,
man.
Dig it. This is the thing. All right.
Lil Monster tried to do it one time, but I ain't catch it.
Okay, dig it. The word understand, it's to play on one's person, right? For instance, to understand, to stand under, to be below,
mm-hmm.
to be demeaned. And so when you're under anything, it's hard for you to get a whole view of what's going on above ground.
Uh-huh.
So when you're under, you have a disadvantage. So, or especially when you're standing under someone or under anything, you can't comprehend it, you can't feel it, you can't vibe with it. So I created the word overstand to get up over that shit,
mm-hmm.
to get a vantage point where you're looking down on some shit.
Okay.
You see what I'm saying?
Yeah.
Like a helicopter got a vantage point over us when we have to get in the street and break.
Right.
They can see us better than the pig call at our level. So
I like that.
The helicopter has an overstanding of us to a great degree. See what I'm saying? So
yeah.
What we have to do, and words control people, man. I'm telling you, when you think, when you speak positive, you think positive. So all the time, I be trying to overstand shit, get a full comprehension.
That's right.
You feel me?
That's right.
So yeah, that's where that came from. That concept came from.
Man, I'm so happy you about that shit, man.
Man, they had me on A. They had me like pops. I'm telling you, me and Pop was like, because when they had Matulu over in Marion, right?
Mm-hmm.
You know, we were getting our correspond on, and he sent me the Thug Code. You know, mm-hmm. of course I endorsed it, right?
Mm-hmm.
Then next thing I know, I got a clipping on Prisoners of War, and they had sent him over Thorns. So then we had to do a whole other trip with the mail, right?
Uh-huh.
And then I just heard that Chin had drowned it, but
he's not well now.
Ain't he? Yeah, it's cool. He was on respiratory.
Yeah,
man.
I'm in jail, too. They telling me this shit.
Yeah.
But the shit that's fucked up is like when Matulu, like, me and him used to talk all the time. When I first came to L.A.,
yeah.
he was like my eyes and ears. I told him everything. Then I think them crackers got a hit that day. He was like, we was talking every day.
Yeah.
And they just killed that shit. I haven't talked to him in like a year, more than that.
Well, still, they, you know, of course, you got legacy movement problems with the pigs. They
yeah.
can't stand to see you, brother, because you of the bloodline.
You ain't lying.
You got them deep roots.
They're calling me. Hold on one more time.
All right.
Hello?
Yeah.
But, man, they was calling, man, the shit that I couldn't even reading your shit, like how you be saying when you was up in there, niggas like hitting a nigga in the nuts and all that
yeah,
shit.
Yeah.
You ain't lying. I get up there, these motherfuckers calling me nigga, and I'm bugging out. I never had no white people calling me a nigga, and nothing yeah. happened. And in this jail I was at, you get 7 years if you touch the police, no matter what.
What?
7 years, no matter what. Because I was in maximum security.
At Dannemora, huh?
And Dannemora.
Yeah.
Then they had me in a special program, like a federal program they got called APPU, Advanced Placement, something.
Yeah.
Where it's all, like, notorious motherfuckers.
Yeah.
So
yeah.
I'm up in there with niggas with 80. Damn, one more time.
All right.
Hello.
Yeah.
I'm up in there with niggas with 80 years, 60 years, and I'm doing 1.5 to 4.5.
Yeah.
And I'm knowing my life in danger. These niggas ain't never getting out.
Yeah, I seen moms on on Team Summit, she was explaining that, right? That they had you in the maximum security prison.
Yeah.
And I was like,
locked down 23 hours a day.
That's how they had me.
Before I even broke a rule.
And that's heavy. They didn't give you the opportunity to break one.
They was like, it's for my own protection because I wouldn't sign into PC.
Oh, fuck that.
So they got mad, right? Because he was telling me, you're going to die in here. You're going to die. And I said, well, I'm going to just have to die. I'm not signing no PC. He's like, well, we're going to put you in IPC. That's involuntary protective custody.
Right, right.
So I'm fighting. I'm getting lawyers to fight me to get out of IPC to get me in population. Because they put me in population the first day I got there, right?
Was it cool?
Huh? Hell yeah. Even though I'm on the other side, I'm with all enemies. These niggas hate me because I'm throwing the west side.
That's
I'm banging
right.
on the east coast.
That's
I'm
right.
screaming west side, nigga.
Right.
Any team, everything. So, when I get there, the pigs didn't give me no, they didn't give me no toiletries. You know, when you come there, you get that cot and don't get nothing else. They made me like, it was a bloody cot, blood all on the cot, no nothing. They left me in population for like 2 hours. In 2 hours, I had everything I needed. Niggas brought me toothpaste, toothbrushes, banger.
Man.
Niggas were bringing me knives, weed, heroin, cocaine, everything I wanted. I was like, nah, I'm cool, homie. I don't
That's
need
real.
That. I gave niggas the bangers back. I didn't want no bangers. They weren't about to set me up for nothing.
That's
it was
real.
Three murders there while I was there.
Damn, I bet shit was jumping up. You was like, damn,
We had the highest level of murders in New York State.
Damn.
Niggas was getting murdered, man. Niggas with the same time I was having.
Down the Moore, huh?
Yep, they crazy up there.
It was popping.
Crazy up there. Riot,
you know
they
what?
Had riot.
They been hooking you up on the videos. Were you happy with your videos?
Yeah, no doubt. I wanted just to keep my face out there.
Yeah, they shot that shit.
Yeah, we finna shoot another video this Wednesday.
That's cool, man.
Me and Dre finna do this shit called California Love with Roger.
Oh, okay.
It's gonna be the bomb, man. Give it up for California, man.
Yeah, I'd be glad to see you back out there too, man.
Oh, I got to take it all back, man. I won't be happy till I do it, because they got to be sorry for what they did.
I'm telling you, hey, I'm with you, man.
We got to.
Hey, but check it out. I want to come down and chill with you, man.
Come on, man. What's up? I'll be having operations from the bottom.
Yeah.
They be up in there with me kicking it.
Yeah, I like them. I gave a shout out to them, yeah. But I'm telling you, I got some lyrics, man.
Come on, you come with some lyrics, you can spit on any one of the songs I got.
I got some shit, I'm telling you.
That's for sure. We could do a song. You just got to come on. I'm in the studio today. I'm in the studio every day.
Okay, but what about Friday?
Friday, I'll be there. That's when Sister Soulja coming, too.
Okay, I'm going to call you. What time are you, before you be going?
I don't leave until 1 o'clock.
Okay, I'm going to call you, man.
All right.
All right.
I'll be here, man.
Oh, I love you, man.
One love. Love you,
hey,
too.
Hey, man, watch yourself, brother.
No doubt.
I hate to have to come there and test shit up for you.
Nah.
I'm telling you, don't send me back to Monster Bowl.
All right, man.
All right.
Come check me, man.
I will.
All right.
All right.